Such humble beginnings. But it's time to move on now. Hey pets, this is Stormy. Thank you so much for joining me for another episode of Stormy Plays Waking Up in 1.8. I can't wait to show you guys what I put together. I hope you like it. First of all, here's our minecart track. I went ahead and laid this. And didn't take too long because Vex did most of the hard stuff, so that's not going to be something we're probably going to use a whole lot after now, but you know, I tried to make it at least well lit and stuff. So I hope everybody is doing well today. I am doing quite well myself. Thank you so much. We have an action-packed, well, I don't know about action-packed, but there's a lot to do today. So we're going to take this minecart track, and then we are going to look at our new storage room and stuff. I went ahead and mined out all the iron that was in here, and it's 21 pieces, and I very carefully managed to mine it without screwing up that gravel. There are a couple pieces of the iron that are like right up there. If you're playing this map, be very careful, or maybe they're up there. I don't remember, but they're super close to the gravel, and if you're not careful, you'll update that gravel and it will all fall, and then you have to dig through it to get out that doorway there. I flattened all this out, got the chest that was full of blocks. Oh, I have smooth lighting off. Let me fix that real quick. Where's it at? Smooth lighting, there it is. I was checking light levels in the base, and the easiest way, one of the easiest ways to do that is turn smooth lighting off. Here's our mushrooms. This is water underneath leaf blocks. Since we don't have grass blocks, it seemed like a fun way to kind of make it look a little bit, well, you know, grassy and cozy and stuff. Look at the cute little baby mushroom. He's so cute. Also, these two trees will stay. I put glowstone in those. So here it is, you guys. These trees here will be cut down as we need, but and you know, obviously I can plant whatever we need, but these ones will stay. This is our storage room. I thought it was kind of a fun little just something different, you know. You make so many storage rooms when you play these kind of maps, and I like to make each one kind of unique and stuff, so that was what I did here. Probably inspired by my trip to Colorado, all the trees and stuff. Yeah, and then you come around up here. And then here's our enchanting table, and this is a powered up enchanting table to level 30. This one over here is obviously a little one. Now, behind, back behind this is still, I haven't skinned it yet, so it's not, back here is not very pretty. I have to fix that still, but I am really pleased with how this turned out. Just a little different, you know? So, damn, I forgot to grab the lapis. I really need to, let's do this real quick. Go ahead and put down a chest, and let's go ahead and grab the lapis. Oh, and I was having fun with the design. A lot of times in these, not so much up here, but like here, I'll put things like in kind of a fun kind of order, but not all the time. Usually with the stairs and the slabs and stuff, and that way I can see what I'm after at a glance. These nether brick slabs, if you guys are wondering, those were in the box with the mobile mushroom farm food, or mobile food unit, or whatever that was. Anyway, you guys, I'm sure you recall. And if you don't, that's okay. Where should I put this? There for now, I guess. Okay. So let's go ahead, and we can't do quite a level 30, but I'd like to do, ooh, creepy cave sound. I'd like to do a decent enchantment on it. Let's see, unbreaking 3, come on, you suck. Well, it'll last a while, right? Hopefully we'll be getting iron, for an anvil, to make an anvil real soon. Unbreaking 3 is okay, since we don't have a whole lot of iron to, I already took it out. to make a lot of picks, but I figured that a pick would probably be the best use of our iron for right now. So, because spawners, if you have a decent pick to take out spawners, it is super helpful. So there was a grassroots movement to make sure that Squish here didn't get cooked and eaten. And I came in one day to work on the storage unit and I found she's named. Little elves must have found a name tag in an anvil and named Squish. So we have Squish. Also, she is our little mascot here. I have her tied up. I might eventually untie her knot there and let her roam, but I'm a little bit afraid she'll get hurt. I haven't done anything down there. We have, oh, there's a bunch of golden apples. Let's go ahead and put the chapters in the box. Whoops, here. Where's, let's see, Lucid Dreaming, chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, chapter 4. And then here we have the wools that we've gotten so far. So let's go ahead and put these on the monument, shall we, pets? Let's start out the episode with a happy little bit of win, because with this, well, with any CTM map, but especially with waking up, you never quite know how much win you're going to be treated to. So, white wool, get. Orange wool, get. And magenta wool, get. Well, there we go, you guys. We are off to a fantastic start as far as gathering wool. Yeah. And then here's the chapter monument. And so, let's see. Yeah, I think that about covers the things. Oh, I can go ahead and turn. I turned the sound way down for the minecart ride because that was loud, and it's players if you want to turn down the minecart. I had to sit there and fiddle around with it because I didn't actually know how. So I'm taking mushrooms so we can refill our mushroom stew. I have high hopes to find a flipping what's it called? Potato this episode. And I could be using our the spawner in our base back there to try to get a potato, but well, I was thinking we would get one by now because I thought about making a real basic grinder back at our first base to try to, you know, grind some zombies, get a potato, you know, be happy, whatever, but no. I decided that surely it wouldn't take that long to get a damn potato. I mean, really. Sorry if that sounded weird. I just adjusted my microphone. I have to have it in just the right spot to try to minimize that audio interference thing that we get. So yeah. So let's get this going. We're only 8 minutes into the damn episode. Oh, hello, zombie. You know what? I'm not gonna go play in there quite yet. I have something else to do first. We're gonna go in here first. But first, there's a thing. Let's be very, very careful here. Let's see, because there is a excuse me, there's a secret down here. Let's see if we can see it. Not quite yet. It's one of those things that you're not, it's not that obvious. It's not that easy to find. But if you know it's there, you know, obviously you know it's there. But if you know Vex's penchant for hiding things in the intersection base, you'd probably find it because you would go off looking for it. I hear a zombie. It sounds awfully close. What's the hostile creature sound at? Okay. Let's see. I still don't see it. And that's just terrifying. It's just terrifying. Oh God. This is nerve-wracking. Fortunately, Vex was nice enough to not make any of these fish. That would be a disaster. Hum da dum da dum. So, I hope everybody is ready for today's episode. I know I am. I have actually really been looking forward to it. I like Helix Cavern. It's a cool area. So, For anybody who isn't familiar with it, I won't spoil it, but it really is a neat area. It just looks cool. So, yeah. At the moment, there's not a whole lot to say. We're carefully digging our way down. Where the hell is it? Pass it? No. No, we didn't pass it. I know it's almost at the bottom of this pit, I guess would be a good term for it. So, yeah, but we obviously have to be super damn careful 'cause that's void down there. Oh, I should be seeing it by now. Where's it at? I know it's down here. I know it's here. Well, we'll keep going, I guess. We'll find it sooner or later. Maybe it's below us, so I can't see it. What I'm looking for, if I recall correctly, there's a couple of pieces of gravel. Yeah, there it is. Okay, cool. I knew damn good and well it was down here. I was afraid he had maybe taken it out or something. I don't know. I was hoping not. It's a decent secret. So let's go ahead and just to prevent accidents, let's do this. And then, because you can never be too careful, let's put a second row of cobble between us and that terrifying blackness known as the void. There, we finally made it. Oh, hey, Flint. There's a creeper in there. There's two creepers in there? Or is that the same? No, there's two creepers. And I was actually sitting here when I put the two pieces of cobble down, and I thought, there's three creepers! I don't think there's any creeper spawners in there, pets. That's just bad luck. But I was sitting here thinking, put two layers of cobble just in case there's a creeper somewhere, but I didn't realize it was actually something to think about. And obviously, the sign says it's a secret to everybody. And for anybody who doesn't know, that is a reference to the original NES Zelda games, so. Yeah. Let's see what we have. A power 3 bow, which beats the hell out of our power 1 bow. Efficiency 1 axe, which we already have. Ooh, nice. Nice. Metal armor. Power 1 bow. Stuff. Aw, yeah. Diamond helmet. Nice. Thank you, Vetches. But unfortunately, no chest plate. I was really hoping for an iron chest plate, so. But no such luck. I'll go ahead, we'll trade out our power one bow for our power three bow. And I'll come and get the rest of that off camera. But for right now, let's get back up here into Helix Cavern and see what kind of trouble we can find to get into, I suppose. Oh, and just in case you guys are wondering, we're still rocking the diving helmet, an unbreaking leather tunic, unbreaking 2 iron leggings, and the protection 4, feather falling 4, gold boots that were in the with the gold armor in the wool room at Boomer Castle. There we go. That took entirely too damn long to say. Let's get into Helix Cavern, because why not? I don't think this is booby-trapped, so, and I think I'd remember, but I'm still going to go carefully just to be sure. This area is not that hard. It really isn't. But there are some very nice resources in here that I'm after. So that's why I came in here first, although I don't think it's technically the first area you're supposed to do in the intersection, but it's the first one we're doing. Oh, and I'm using the sharpness 3. Ow! It's, yeah, sharpness 3, knockback 1 iron sword that was in the box in the wool room. The diamond sword that we got is in a chest. We still have it. Although I don't know what I thought that you guys would think that I might have done with it. We haven't lost all our inventory yet to a death. We're not quite to that point of the map. Although it's been possible, but. We haven't, so yay. So let's go ahead and this place I'm going to light up the best I can because there's a lot of resources in here. There's coal in here, there's iron in here. So you know, it's kind of like a mine. And although I've been trying not to light up a whole lot for purposes of helping with natural spawns, this place, well, I figure we can at least light up the areas we go really well, so. That is my plan, pets. Now, there is down there is Helix Depths. That is the next dungeon that we'll be doing after we finish this part. So probably in the next episode or two. So far, every single area we've done is taking quite a bit more time and episodes than I expected it to. So, but sometime in the next couple of episodes, we'll be going into Helix Depths back there. And that is the specific dungeon I was thinking of when I said, you know, do it with no void fog. It's that dungeon down there, so. Great. We've already used a stack of torches. Fortunately, there's a lot of coal in here. There's also something else in here that will help us get that coal. I'm just hoping I can find it, you know, relatively quickly instead of having to wander all over the place to find it. Because this area is actually complicated, but it looks really cool. Especially, ow, in Vex's DevCom. Hold on a second, I'll look around a little bit more, but I can't right now. But in Vex's DevCom, he was complaining about the light glitches, and they really were pretty significant. But you can see, I don't know how well you guys are going to be able to see on YouTube, but you can see pretty well, I think, and it looks really cool, so I hope you guys can see okay. Man, we're already almost out of food. Which brings to mind, so I was watching Zisto play Ragecraft yesterday. And it's a CTM map that he's working on, and it looks pretty tough, although I might give it a try. On my own, and then go, you know, go from there. But anyway, that's not what I was actually getting at. He was talking about sprint jumping, and that it's not something that you want to do all the time. It can help you get away from monsters, but, you know, if you don't have a lot of food, obviously it's something you don't really want to do. You know, you don't want to be jumping around like a chicken with its head cut off when you don't have much food. And I had to laugh at that, because somebody actually said, you know, hey, Stormy, why are you sprint jumping? You don't have much food. To which I replied, it's habit. I try not to, but it is habit. So Zisto saying that yesterday, I had to laugh. Although I don't think I play like a chicken with my head cut off. Sometimes my attention is kind of all over the place. But overall, I think my play style is pretty well, you know, reasonable. But I had to laugh at it because, you know, the timing of it. Power Miner 2000. It's not quite what I was looking for. Golden Pick with Efficiency 10, Unbreaking 5, and Fortune 10. This pick. Let's see. How quickly can we mine coal with it? Let's find a good. There are fish in here, so we do want to be careful. They're mixed in. Ah, nice. All the coal. Nice. Very nice. Thank you, Vex. But I just about, stepped in a hole and went, but yeah. Awesome, awesome, awesome pick is awesome. Thank you, Vetches, thank you. Hello, Glowy Bo. Hello, Lag, how are you? I did reboot my computer before I recorded, so hopefully, you know what? I could use some Ender Pearls. Come here. Ooh, thank you. Whoa, he died twice. Ow. I tend to forget about that if you go into your menu during a sound effect, the sound effect will play two times. Yeah, this looks so cool. And there's actually quite a bit to this area. So, it's not the first area you're supposed to do in the intersection, but like I said, I wanted to. For one thing, there's a whole lot of resources. For another thing, there's a couple of good picks. So I suppose I probably shouldn't have used three iron ingots to make an iron pick when I know that I think there's a couple of picks in here, if I recall correctly. But, well, I'm not worried about always being uber efficient, like you guys could ever possibly think that I am. But I just pretty much play the way I want to play. So. Although I still don't think I play like a chicken with its head cut off either. In that I always try to make sure I have, my kit put together, and I will go forward and then back out of the area as necessary. I don't just barge forward through the areas and die repeatedly. Some people, they do. Some people, that's their play style. They'll run into a dungeon willy-nilly, and that's gonna hurt. And then they will they'll run into a dungeon willy-nilly, and then they'll die like repeatedly. And each time they'll put down some torches and whatnot, and they can make it through a map that way. That's not my taste of for playing, but it's a method you can use. I've seen people do it on YouTube, so I'm not gonna say who, but I don't watch them very often because their play style irritates me. So, ow, stop that! I see you up. You know what? You're far enough away, I'm just gonna walk. I'm not gonna use the arrows. I started up that way and changed my mind because I have a vague idea that what I'm looking for isn't up that high. This place is very confusing. Fiddlesticks. I wasn't looking for you. This level's actually confusing. I saw that just then. Crap. Vex. Cave spiders? Okay, we do not want creepers to explode. Obviously, that's bad. Because there's a lot of fish, and we don't want these ribbons that we're on to crumble. Vex calls them ribbons, which makes sense. They kind of are ribbony. And I have to be super careful with this pig. Our sword's almost dead? Really? Ugh. Well, we're almost out of torches, so I'll tell you guys what. Let's grab a little more coal. Although now I'll mine some more of the coal out of the room that's next to the Victory Monument. I didn't get much coal out of there, knowing that these fortune picks are in here. Because I'm sure there's another one. Anyway, alright, you guys, so I'm going to pause, run back to base. Hopefully, this one won't have 16 cuts to it. But I'm going to pause and run back to base and refill coal. And then I'll be back and we'll do a little bit more before we run out of time for today. So I will see you all in a bit. Hang tight. Yep, don't go
Okay,
away.
gang, I'm back. I have quite a few more torches, so I think we'll be good to go for a bit. But as I was looking over the area we had been to walk back in here, something caught my attention. So let's go back there and see if we can locate it again. Let's see if it's anything. Excuse me, I don't know what the heck. My voice is like wobbly or something. I don't know why. Shouldn't be. Do, 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 but it is. My husband and I often have what I call the shouldn't be, but it is argument, where like I'll be like, the back gate isn't shutting, and he'll be like, well, it should be, but it isn't. Should be, but it isn't. I mean, like that. So, I have taken great pains to avoid the should be, but it isn't, or shouldn't be, but it is school of thought. The other day we were discussing something and I opened my mouth and said something and he opened his mouth and said, well, and I said, I'm not even going there. I'm not getting into this should be, but it isn't. And he started laughing. It was on top of one of these pillars, but where was it? I know I saw something on top of one of the pillars that's out in the lava. Yeah, there it is, the glass block. I was running by there on the other side of the thing. My render distance must be up really high, and I don't even think it's on fart distance. And what's it called? Hex. It looks, because the render distance says like 23 far plus, it looks like it says 23 fart. This is another Power Miner 2000. I'm going to leave that here just in case we lose the one we have. Become sad pandas. Because this could be frightening, but we're going to do it anyways. I guess I'll grab that coal. There we go. I'm going to toss it in there with that. There we go. Squat again. We have, by the way, like almost 2 stacks of signs. Now, granted, a stack of signs is only 16 signs, but I could enderpearl, but the thing is, we're going to have to get back too. And I don't want to use 2 enderpearls just out of laziness to avoid bridging. It's not dangerous. This is not a dangerous level. This part of it anyway. Is this fish? No, this isn't fish. Good. Good to know. Fish? No fish? Okay. I'm like paranoid. Oh, hey, it's a chest. Were there trap chests when he made this? I don't think there were, but I'm going to just... Ooh, nice prize. Thank you, Vex. Huh. That's cool. I don't think... He didn't show that in his DevCom. He didn't show all the secrets in his DevCom. And yeah, I realized his DevCom came out like 3 years ago. I kind of forgot. When I've mentioned it, I rewatched it like last fall. I was sick. And I rewatched Waking Up. That's the last time I saw it. So, to me, it was much more recent than when it was actually done. So now let's get back over here to the ribbon that we were on, now that we've found that little treasure. Yeah, that's a nice little find. And just about right for how hard it was to get to. It shouldn't have been anything too outrageous because it wasn't hard to get to. The only tricky part about it was noticing it. I just happened to... I guess the lava hit it just right. It's not that dark there, at least. Oh, clouds are on. I really don't care. We're not where they are anyways. Do 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 do. It's been a few hours since I recorded, like for real. Yeah, it's been that was earlier today. So now my kids are home from school and my husband's home from work, but my kids are on their computers and my husband is outside working on a car. So,
yep.
That's kind of his he hasn't been a mechanic as an actual, like, source of job, as a job, in probably 20 years. It was before we got married. Except he's a freight car, or a train car mechanic. And I hear blazes. And I see baby cave spiders. And all of a sudden, things got interesting. Now, down there, there's not a whole lot of, or there's no spawners down there, as far as I know. But once you get up on these ribbons, you start running into spawners. I'm trying to follow that. Did I just look at that Enderman? I hope not. Nothing personal, Ender Bob. Is that squids I see in the lava falls, or is that cave spiders? I can't tell. I really can't tell. That's kind of unnerving. So is that. Get away! At least we have this knockback sword on this... in this area, on these ribbons. Sorry, I was distracted. Oh, crap. Here comes all the bad guys ever. Okay, not all the bad guys ever. But a few. I've been playing a map just for fun. It's a newer map. It just came out. It's a series of islands in the void. The only problem is that there's, in the beginning of the map, apparently there's no honeypots. By the way, iron. I know I've been walking by iron, and I, you know, haven't said anything like, hey, look, there's iron, but hey, look, there's iron there. Anyway, so there's a series of islands in the void, and it's not, it's just, you know, like each dungeon is its own area in void. It's not, the void isn't a major player yet in the map. I'm only in like the first area.
But the problem is, and I did mention it on the forums. Ow, hey! Oh, I see how it is. I get distracted fighting the fat spider, and then the cave spider comes up behind me and bites me in the butt. Anyway, everywhere I go on this map, like, I have to fight all the, well, max natural spawn, because there's nowhere for them to spawn. And I mentioned to the guy that, hey, you might want to put some honeypots in here. And he said there are honeypots later in the map. They're just, not yet. And, which is fine. That's okay. But, if you're gonna do that, you kind of probably should give the player, some kind of an unbreaking, bonker of some sort. Because when you are letting the natural spawn rate be what it's going to be, and you have your world set up with very little spawning space, there's going to be 87 zombies every time the player turns a corner. And I am really tired of breaking stone swords, although there are unlimited stone swords, but I'm really tired of breaking the damn things. So, just a thought. I won't tell you guys what map it is, of course, I never do. But I usually kind of, because I know some of you guys are mappers, so just thoughts as I have them, you know. If you're going to have a series of islands in void, please either give honeypots to help draw off some of the spawns, or the appropriate bonker, like a lacerator or a battle sign or a tulip. I've had a tulip before. I've had any number of things, so just something like that. So we're working our way up this ribbon, and I don't know, like, each... Ow! There's a series of ribbons that go from the bottom of the area to the top of the area. Some of them are interconnected, but not all of them are. And, some of them, most of them, actually go somewhere. So, and I saw that. Oh, good. He immediately went into, I see spawner sparks. Oh, good. I'm really scared of having a silverfish apocalypse on these ribbons, because obviously that would be bad. There's not a whole lot of extra blocks around here for that kind of shenanigan. Is that the wool? I want up there to the book. The book's up there, see? And there's things up there that I want. So, I'm not going to the wool quite yet. Yo, shit. Run! Damn it! Aw, fiddle fudge. Fish. So, we get away from the explosion, and now there's fish. Well, at least there's plenty of blocks for them to go into. Some of these are fish, but not all. Most of them, I think, are not fish. I think fish are just sprinkled liberally throughout this particular ribbon. I think the other ribbons are more fishful. And this episode might run a little bit long, but this is a big area. So as long as you guys don't mind an episode that's close to 40 minutes, I would like to at least get up to the book in this episode. So I'm never sure. Should I make the episodes a little bit longer? Or, like, when I'm watching videos, I don't mind 40-minute episodes. Like, if Vex or Paul Soares Jr. upload a 40-minute video of a series I'm actually watching. I haven't watched many of Paul Soares Jr.'s most recent stuff, which is sad. But anyways, that's not the point. Point is, a 40-minute video of Fallout New Vegas, for example, that's, like, bonus. You know, I get my chores done, and then I settle my little tushy down with the fresh drink and some headphones, and I enjoy the video. But not everybody has my flexibility in their schedule. I have, that was a little bit of a pun, because I'm double-jointed, and thus very flexible anyways. So, yeah, not everybody has my flexibility. My son does. Let's go ahead and drink the fire resist potion, because pretending that we're not going to need to is just denying the reality. You know what? You could come here. I could use a few more blaze rods. Ow! I didn't say come here and punch me, you butthead! You know what? I don't feel like messing with you. So I'm just gonna see if I can avoid it all together. I want those creepers away from that book box.
and away from blowing things up and away. Yeah, this is not that hard. There's some fish spawners, there's some cave spider spawners, there's some blaze spawners, and that's about it. It's not a big deal. I do want some of this gold because I want night vision potions. It'll be super damn handy for the next area. So, the next area being, well, I don't know, maybe for this area too. I don't know. I like night vision. So, power miner 4,000. If you'll recall, the gold pick was the power miner 2,000. This is the iron equivalent, and this pick is amazing. It has efficiency 10, unbreaking 5, fortune 4. This pick is like the spawner destroyer, super damn deluxe forever and ever, and also feather falling boots because we are up on here. You know what? How about if you just die? So I think next episode, we will take a field trip back to Boomer Castle and Chapter 11, and I will hop into creative mode, or not creative mode, even spectator mode, and we'll take a look at that trap. I will not keep, shoot. I didn't realize it was going to burnt the gold. Let's not burnt gold because fish. Anyway, we're going to look at the trap in spectator mode. Spectator mode because I have a feeling there's no way to not trigger it as long as those spawners are active. They won't be active in spectator mode. Because I know it's a spawner-based trap. It's just, duh. Of course it's a spawner-based trap. So, but I did some testing and that's fish, yep. Okay, so the burp pick doesn't burp the fish blocks quite as quick, so that's helpful. Anyway, so I did some testing in a backup save, and yeah, it's really hard to see what the trap's made of. So we're going to poke at that, just take a look at it in spectator mode. But if, by some fluke of a chance, I end up, some piece of iron ore floats apart from the rest and somehow is there, I won't keep any ore if we accidentally pick any up. So, obviously. Anytime I do that, get into another mode to look at a trap or something, a lot of times I'm satisfying my curiosity just as much as anything else. But I won't keep anything I get because that's not fair. Especially that trap. You're not meant to have iron yet. I can pretty much tell you guys that iron is not meant. You're not meant to be able to get to it. So, yeah. As long as I know that Vex, made it to where you can't get the iron, I know I'm not going to keep it, obviously. And that trap, as far as I can tell, is almost unavoidably blowing up business. Bad blaze. So there's the wool. And we could get to that. We're at 39 minutes already. So I think I'll wait. But that explosion that I ran away from, that blew up in such a way as to make kind of a bridge so that we can get over to there from here. And that's helpful. Otherwise, we'd have to go all the way back down. Except, I'm going all the way back down anyway, because we're not getting the wool yet. And I want to go drop off some of this amazingness stuff. It's not just amazing stuff. It's stuff made from pure amazingness. The pick. The pick is pure amazing. So, I want to go drop that off. Well, actually, I'm not dropping it off. We're going to use it. But, I want to get the iron, because I want to make an anvil. So I'm going to be working on that probably between episodes. There was iron. I showed you guys the iron on this ribbon. I'm going to get that. And then next episode, we'll go ahead and get the wool out of here. And then if we have time, we'll start into the Helix Depths. I like that dungeon. I like the Helix Depths. Crap, we're not on the right place, are we? But I want to have some night vision potion because most of the LPs of this map are done in, darkness and void. So, if we can do it without void fog and with a night vision potion, well, that'll make it a little different. A little more, just give it a different flavor from, Vex's DevCom. Well, okay, I don't... It's not just a lack of void fog and a night vision potion gonna make the difference. I can't be Vex flavored. He's his own flavor, so yeah. But anyway, you guys, so I guess I'm going to go because I don't actually want to have an hour-long episode, but I will see you all real soon. In the meantime, I was like, hey, wait a minute, where's the doorway? It's right there. Maybe I'll put some sandstone around it just because sandstone kind of glows and it might be handy. Anyway, I will see you all real soon. Take care. Bye now. Squish, don't turn your back on me, you naughty, naughty cow. Look at this lead I found. Mm. You broke it again. That's the second time. All right, fine. I'll tell you what, Squish. I'll let you wander, but here's the deal. Do not get killed, okay? The people that snuck in here and named you would never believe I didn't mean for it to happen. Okay? Deal? Look at me, Squish. Squish.